Welcome to this Bend the Curve webcast. Bend the Curve is an educational campaign developed by NEHI with support from the WellPoint Foundation, aimed at providing healthcare leaders with actionable ways to reduce spending without impacting quality in an effort to create high-value healthcare. The campaign covers seven critical areas of wasteful healthcare spending and seeks to provide healthcare professionals with data to identify where costs can be reduced and recommendations for actionable solutions. In this webcast, we'll be looking at the problem of antibiotic overuse. Targeting the $63 billion spent annually on antibiotic overuse requires building on a set of proven practices and implementing policy actions that target the root causes of the problem. These include implementing regulatory reform, promoting the use of outcomes-based reimbursements, and reducing antibiotic use in critical patients, among others. But before we talk about the tools healthcare leaders can utilize to reduce antibiotic overuse, we first have to talk about the size and scope of this very real healthcare issue. The inappropriate use of antibiotics risks more than just excess spending. Overuse increases the risks of antibiotic resistance, which helps to cancel out the curative power of these therapies, and leads to the rise of superbugs, deadly new infections that can wreak havoc on at-risk patients. These antibiotic-resistant infections, or ARIs, such as MRSA and C. diff, are a significant cause of mortality. In 2005, more than 9,000 people died from MRSA infections alone. This overuse of antibiotics costs the healthcare system a significant amount in financial terms each year. About $20 billion in excess healthcare costs, and $35 billion in societal costs. This staggering $60-plus billion price tag, however, does leave a lot of room for improvement. Reducing ARIs by just 20% would save $3 to $5 billion a year in healthcare costs. The causes of antibiotic overuse are complex and systemic, resulting from overprescribing, patient preferences, the non-therapeutic treatment of animals, and a lack of evidence-based research. For example, doctors, concerned over malpractice and sometimes pressured by patients who want them to prescribe antibiotics, even when appropriate, can also be a driver of antibiotic overuse. About 70% of all the antibiotics used in the United States are used in the non-therapeutic treatment of farm animals and food stocks. In addition, there's a lack of evidence-based research on the appropriate use of antibiotics, and a lot more work needs to be done in this area. Reducing antibiotic overuse requires building on a coordinated set of proven practices in the field, coupled with policy actions in the public and private sectors. The following slides talk a bit more about how these proven practices and policy actions can help to address this critical health policy issue. One proven way of reducing antibiotic overuse links to one of our other bend the curve topics, vaccines. As researchers have found, the greater use of flu shots was accompanied by a reduction in prescriptions for antibiotics. Researchers in Canada recently found that hospital guidelines focused on curbing the use of antibiotics can lower the number of prescriptions written for them. It's a promising practice towards addressing this issue. Another study found that measuring levels of the chemical PCT in the body is an effective and innovative way of monitoring the presence of an infection and guiding the duration of antibiotic treatment for a patient. This reduces the likelihood of administering antibiotics past the point where they're effective, particularly in critical patients. One of the more well-known and effective campaigns to reduce the use of antibiotics is the CDC's Get Smart, Know When Antibiotics Work program, a comprehensive public health effort directed at healthcare professionals, parents, and the public. The CDC's program has led to an impressive 20% decrease in the prescribing of antibiotics for upper respiratory infections and a 13% decrease in prescribing for all office visits among both children and adults. Given the issues providers face regarding the prescription of antibiotics, it's clear that the payment system must be reformed to encourage these providers to do more to address this issue. One way is to encourage practices that link payment reimbursements to adherence to evidence-based guidelines that reduce the use of antibiotic classes that promote MRSA colonization. One final promising way to reduce antibiotic overuse is regulatory reform by the FDA regarding the regulations concerning antibiotic use in livestock. That brings us to the end of this Bend the Curve webcast. We hope that the webcast has been enjoyable and informative. If you'd like a copy of this presentation in PowerPoint form, or you'd like to learn more about this or any of the other Bend the Curve topics, please visit the website at www.nehi.net/bendthecurve. On the website, you'll find the Healthcare Leader's Guide to High-Value Healthcare, policy briefs, PowerPoint presentations, and more of these webcasts. We encourage you to use these tools to educate your colleagues, as well as to identify and implement successful solutions aimed at addressing the very real problem of healthcare waste in your organizations and communities. Thank you, and take care.